time tomorrow, we could know if there is a change in power in the state Senate. Six Republican state senators are facing a recall challenge in districts across the state. One of the most watched races is in the 8th District, pitting Senator Alberta Darling against State Rep. Sandy Pash.
New at 10, 12 News' Brennan Conway begins our team coverage live from Shorewood, where they are expecting a huge turnout.
And Kathy, the results tomorrow, we're being told, will hinge on turnout. Which side can motivate their base in this unusual election? And both sides are spending these final hours making sure their supporters get to the polls. From Republicans in Waukesha,
oh, we got a map of the turf,
to Democrats in Glendale, both sides are making a final push to get out the vote.
To balance Wisconsin's budget.
While the candidates and third-party groups are spending millions on ads, it's these person-to-person contacts that experts say can really motivate voters. The Democratic Party says they've reached more than 2.1 million voters statewide since the recall started.
We had about at least 730,000 contacts over the weekend into today.
The state Republican Party won't give specific numbers in their voter outreach, only saying they are making thousands and thousands of phone calls. Volunteers say their message is being heard.
I'm cautiously optimistic. Take nothing for granted, but I think we're going to be okay.
The Democratic third-party group We Are Wisconsin is also running a significant ground game. They say statewide they've knocked down 125,000 doors over the weekend.
Everyone should search their heart and see if there's any good reason to stay home, because there really isn't.
The candidates are pounding the pavement themselves. Alberta Darling and Sandy Pash are ringing doors, making their final pitch to voters.
We know that people do care about the issues that I care about, and that they want to get our state going back in the direction that represents Wisconsin values.
We are standing up for the citizens of Wisconsin. The question has to be asked, who's in control? The citizens who voted in November, or the special interests who are in our state today trying to take it over?
Both sides say they are confident heading into tomorrow's election, but of course they also say that they are all too close. All six of those races are too close to call at this point confidently, and they say they will be working until those polls close tomorrow at 8 p.m. to make sure that they do get every voter out to the poll. Reporting live in Shorewood, Brendan Conway, WISN 12 News.